Hello all, welcome back to AVK's Academy. Today we will understand one important topic that is continued in the recent times, that is RBI versus central government. So you know very well RBI Act was framed in the year 1934, which is called the Banker's Bank, which is called the Bank to the Central Government, which is also called the Monetary Policy Preparing Authority in India, highest bank, that is Central Bank or else Reserve Bank of India. In RBI Act of 1934, there are totally 61 sections. And RBI is altogether an autonomous body, that is independent body. Nobody can never interfere into the internal affairs of RBI. But there is section called Section 7, which is breaking the autonomous status of RBI. According to Section 7, the central government may give several directions to RBI only in view of public interest. It is said that so far Section 7 was never imposed by central government. We will understand why it was imposed, how can it be imposed, everything as such. This topic is brought before you by me, that is Shravan Kumar Sambrani. Clear? See, Section 7 cannot be imposed directly. First of all, a letter of consultation must be given to RBI governor. Later, RBI governor will be sending the same issue to something called CBD, that is Central Board of Directors. And there are 20 members in CBD. Later on, the reply will be given to central government. And if the central government is not getting satisfied, then they can impose Section 7. And the reply can be given either by governor of RBI or any other deputy governor, that is recommended by RBI governor. And what are the reasons of imposing Section 7? The first practical reason is, every year RBI will be giving the list of the loans that are issued by them. Whatever are the loans that are issued in one financial year will be announced by RBI. Central government wanted to stop that because they don't want the reality to be bursted out. They don't want the loans that are issued by RBI must be publicized with that. There is something else called PCA norms. PCA means prompt corrective action. That is a tool available with RBI to control the monetary flow of all the scheduled commercial banks. And central government also wanted to involve into the PCA norms of RBI. With that, there is something called NPA, non-performing asset, which is declared by RBI. Several power companies in regard to Allahabad High Court judgment are to be declared as non-performing assets. But the central government again interferes into this also and wanted to give certain relaxation to the power companies. With that, there is something called NBFC, non-banking financial companies. Non-banking financial companies are those which are regulated by RBI according to the Companies Act of 1956, while the banks are being regulated according to Banking Regulation Act of 1949. So they wanted to involve into the NBFC control also. With this all practical reasons, the Section 7 is all set to be imposed. But there are clashes between central government and RBI again and again. But it was never been busted out. It was never been revealed out. It was never been publicized. But this information came to be publicized because of one important deputy governor of RBI called Viral V. Acharya. So, we will understand what is Section 7 saying altogether. See, Section 7 exactly, the text says that first of all, it must be given to the governor, then he will be transferring to the CBD, that is Central Board of Directors, then there will be a decision announced. That is the same thing. Same. The central government may from time to time give such directions to the bank as it may after consultation with the governor of the bank only in view of public interest. This is very important, people. With that, subject to any such direction, the general superintendence and the direction of the affairs and business of the bank shall be conducted by Central Board of Directors, which may exercise all powers and do all acts and things which may be exercised or done by the bank. Same thing. Same as otherwise provided in regulations made by the Central Board, the governor and in absence, the deputy governor nominated by him in this behalf shall also have the powers of general superintendence and directions of the affairs and business of the bank, and may exercise all powers and do all acts and things which may be exercised or done by the bank. This is what is the section 7 exactly saying. So we will focus on central board of directors. I have said before, there are totally 20 members in central board of directors. There's one governor, 4 deputy governors, 4 directors, 10 executive directors, with that one government officer that is nominated by the central government. So currently the governor of RBI is Urjit Patel, and 4 deputy governors are as follows: N.S. Vishwanathan, Viral V. Acharya, he is the person behind the controversy, B.P. Kanungo, and M.K. Jain. With this, why Section 7 was used? See, one reason here is a classification of non-performing asset. Non-performing asset, yani ki jo loan RBI ke taraf se mila hai, yadi wo vasul nahi kar pa rahe, clear? When they are not able to collect the loans back that are issued, then we consider that as non-performing asset. Clear? Several power projects which are declared as NPA must be provided relief to them. No. Clear? You know that. Prompt corrective action norms to the banks. Government demands nearly 1 lakh crore that was refused by RBI. This is unofficial statement which I am using here. The central government wanted 1 lakh crore to be given as a loan to the central government, but RBI refused to it. This is another problem. Liquidity problem of non-banking financial companies. Okay. What are these terms, non-banking financial companies? All this will make a separate video altogether. But here you can see a cartoon. On one side, Arun Jaitley with a rope, and on the other side, Urjit Patel with a rope altogether. So this is what is exactly the controversy between central government and Reserve Bank of India and Section 7. So in the history, it was never imposed. So it can be a question in every single competitive examination in the upcoming times. For more such videos, please keep watching us, and at the same time, please do subscribe to our channel. Do share our videos in order to share the knowledge as such. Clear? Thank you so much.